Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 14. Do you speak English? 大家好，今天我们学习第十四课。课文的标题是 Do you speak English? 你会讲英语吗？ The story is about an Englishman's amusing experience in France. 这个故事讲的是一个英国人在法国的一段有趣经历。好，在看课文之前呢，我们先来看看本课的关键词和短语 Keywords and expressions. Amusing Experience Wave Ask somebody for a lift Apart from Journey Reach OkayNext, I'm going to have you look at the three questions on the text. Please keep them in mind while you watch and listen. 好，接下来我们还是就课文提三个问题，请大家在看动漫的时候呢，把这些问题想一想。Right. Question number one. What happened when the writer was driving to a town in France?
作者在驱车前往法国的一个小镇的时候，路上发生了什么事情
？Question number two. In which language did the young man reply to the writer's greetings?
那位年轻人是以什么语言来回答作者的问候的
？Question number three. Why did neither of them speak during the journey?
为什么这两个人在途中谁也没有说话
？I had an amusing experience last year. After I had left a small village in the south of France, I drove on to the next town. On the way, a young man waved to me. I stopped and he asked me for a lift.As soon as he had got into the car, I said good morning to him in French, and he replied in the same language. Apart from a few words, I do not know any French at all. Neither of us spoke during the journey. I had nearly reached the town when the young man suddenly said, very slowly,Do you speak English? As I soon learnt, he was English himself.
Right. How did you like the story?
大家喜欢不喜欢这个小故事呢
？Okay. Let's take up those questions again and see if you can answer them.
下面呢，我们再来看看前面的问题。
What happened?When the writer was driving to a town in France.
作者在驱车前往法国的一个小镇的途中发生了什么
?A young man waved to the writer and asked for a lift.
有位年轻人向作者招手要求呢搭一乘车。
In which language did the young man reply to the writer's greetings.
这位年轻人用什么样的语言来回答作者的招呼
?Well, he replied in French.
他呢是用法语来回答他的。
Why did neither of them speak during the journey?
这两人为什么在途中谁也没有说话
?Because Both of them thought the other was French, and both of them knew very little French.
因为这两人都以为对方是法国人，而他们两人呢，都不太懂法语。
All right, that's it for the questions and answers. Now let's move on to the language points.
好，下面呢，我们再来看看本课的语言点。
On the way, a young man waved to me.
在途中，有位年轻人向我招手。 On the way 意思是在途中，在去什么地方的途中要说 On the way to someplace。 请看这个例句。 On my way to work, I was caught in a traffic jam。 在我去上班的路上，我赶上了堵车。 On my way to work, 去上班的路上。Wave 意思是招手、示意。I waved goodbye to him. 我挥手向他告别。I stopped and he asked me for a lift. 我把车停下来，他提出要求搭一程车。Ask somebody for a lift 意思是要求搭便车。给某人搭便车，英文中可以说 give somebody a lift， 也可以说 give somebody a ride。 请看这个例句。 Can you give me a ride to the airport？ 你可以开车送我去机场吗？ Give me a ride 意思是给我搭便车去什么地方。好，我们再看下一句。As soon as he had got into the car, I said good morning to him in French, and he replied in the same language. 他一进车，我就跟他用法语说早上好，他呢，也同样用法语来回答我。As soon as, 意思是一怎么样就怎么样。这个短语通常来连接一个分句。I'll call you as soon as I arrive there. 我一到那就会给你打电话。In the same language, 这里的 the same language 就是指的 French, 同样用同样的语言，也就是前面所说的。用什么语言要用介词 in。He has written an article in English. 他用英语写了一篇文章。Apart from a few words, I do not know any French at all. 除了几个单词以外，我根本就不懂法语。Apart from 意思是除了什么之外，它的意思就相当于 except for。我们来看一个例句。We had a good time except for the weather. 除了天气不太好以外，我们还是玩得很愉快。Not at all 通常是连在一起使用，意思是根本不。I'm not hungry at all. 我一点也不饿。As I soon learned, he was English himself. 我很快了解到，他自己就是英国人。As 在这里是连词，它的意思呢，表示的是正如什么什么的。在语法功能上，它相当于动词的一个宾语。我们来看看这种用法的例句。As we all know,Smoking is very harmful. 大家都知道，吸烟非常有害。As we all know, 可以理解为正如我们大家都知道的那样。这里呢 ，as 在语法的功能上相当于 know 的宾语。As I have told you, I'm very interested in pop music. 我告诉过你。我对流行音乐非常感兴趣。As I have told you, 意思是正如我告诉过你的那样。同样 ,as 也是作为 have told 这个动作的一个宾语，也就是双宾语中的一个宾语。在这个句子中的 himself 是用来强调语气。我们来看一个例句。I myself want to read that book. 我自己还想读那本书呢。这里 myself 是用来表示强调。
Okay, that's it for the language points. Now we'll move on to key structures and usage.
在这里呢，我们要看看过去完成时。过去完成时态是由助动词 had 加上过去分词构成的。过去完成时态呢，主要是用于表现在过去发生的两个动作或事件中哪一个发生在前这样一种情况。下面呢，我们就来看看课文中的带有过去完成时态的句子。好，一起来看一下。
After I had left a small village in the south of France, I drove on to the next town.
我离开法国南部的一个小村子后，继续开车前往下一个城镇。
Had left
是过去完成时，那么它的动作呢，发生在 drove on 之前。好，我们再看下一句。
As soon as he had got into the car, I said good morning to him in French.
他一上车，我就用法语跟他说早上好。
Had got into the car
这一个动作发生在我跟他用法语说早安之前，所以这里用的是过去完成时。
I had nearly reached the town when a young man suddenly said, very slowly, Do you speak English?
当我的车快开到那个小镇的时候，那位年轻人突然开了口，慢慢地说，你会讲英语吗？在这里
had reached
是过去完成时，那么这个动作也是发生在年轻人突然开口说话之前。好，过去完成时态我们就看到这。下面我们看看英文中的三个代词的用法，这三个代词就是 either, neither 和 both。我们来看例句。
Either of them will do.
这两个哪个都行。
Either of them
意思是两者之一。
Neither of the answers is correct.
这两个答案哪个都不对。
Neither
表示两者都不，它是 either 的一种否定形式。
Either 和 neither
作为代词在句中做主语的时候，后面的谓语动词都要用单数形式。那么这里呢，因为是将来时态，所以呢看不出来。在这里大家就可以看出来
，neither of the answers is correct，
要用单数形式。
I like both of them，
他们两个我都喜欢。
Both。
意思是两者都，两个都。那么 both 在这里呢是做宾语，如果 both 在句子中做主语的时候，那么它的谓语动词呢要用复数形式。这篇课文讲的是两个英国人在法国闹的一段有趣的小误会。这两个人彼此都用法语打招呼，大概是懂得入乡随俗的道理。要入乡随俗，在英文中是这么说的
When in Rome, do as the Romans do.
字面上的意思呢是到了罗马，你看罗马人怎么做，你也怎么做。
When in Rome, do as the Romans do.
不过这两个英国人呢，由于法语太差，所以呢一路上憋着也不敢说话，到了最后才闹清自己原来是同胞。在这一点上，我们也可以看出英国人呢个性还是比较保守。另外，大家知道法语呢是一个非常优雅的语言
，French is one of the most beautiful languages in the world，
所以法国人对自己的语言和文化非常自豪。甚至有的法国人为了担心英语的入侵，他们还成立了一个纯洁法语的运动。好，题外话就讲到这儿 ，See you next time。